Hi, I'm Ben Mankiewicz. I'm at the Pickford Center for Motion Picture Studies with the president of the Academy, John Bailey. John, always good to see you.
Thank you, Ben. Good to be here.
First of all, John, thank you. Thanks for doing this. John, what are the Academy Archives?
Well, the Academy Archives are a repository. It was founded in 1991. Since 93, every film that's nominated, producers are requested to submit a print to the Academy Film Archives. So for the last almost 25 years, the archive essentially has a digital print of every movie that's been nominated. And that includes, obviously, the feature films, documentaries, animation, shorts.
Everything, every category.
Every category.
This is the 90th anniversary of the Academy. Does that change the mission this year? Is there anything, is your effort heightened in a significant anniversary year like this?
Well, looking back, you know, for the entire history of the Academy, which is the late silent era when the Academy was founded in 1927, where two films were honored, Wings and Sunrise. And the show is going to look at that entire history and pay respect to the entire broad spectrum of the filmmaking, you know, categories.
Some of what the archive has will have, I think, an immediate impact on people because the history is right there in photographs.
When you go to the Academy building on Wilshire Boulevard, peppered throughout all the different offices are, you know, photographs from the Herrick Library's own archives of actors and scenes from movies, but there are also a tremendous number of photographs behind the scenes and of the actual, you know, history of the Academy Awards themselves, starting with the earliest days when, you know, the awards were held at Roosevelt Hotel. You can't come to the Academy offices and walk through the hallways without being acutely aware of this 90-year history.
How many photographs the archive have?
The Herrick Library houses all of the paper materials, and I think it includes 10 million photographs. Then we have all of the one sheets, lobby cards, you know, all these kind of things. There's a whole collection.
The Academy's role in preservation has changed dramatically. It was odd to an outsider that so much film preservation in this country was handled by organizations that weren't the Academy. But now you guys have jumped in with both feet.
The Academy has interlocking relationships with a lot of other film archives around the world. And also, you know, you mentioned in terms of restoration, the Academy Film Archives works very closely, like with the Film Foundation and Martin Scorsese, the National Film Preservation Foundation, the UCLA Film Archives, and sometimes we jointly, you know, three or four institutions work together to you know, restore and preserve an old film.
What's the mission of the archives?
The mission of the archives is to preserve the historical record of American cinema and to restore work as well. Right now, the archive has two films that they're actively involved in restoring. 1946, Edgar Olmert's classic, extremely low-budget noir film, Detour.
Yeah.
And the other film I believe the archive is actively restoring is 1960s Tunes of Glory, Ronald Neame's film with Alec Guinness.
Has the mission of the archives changed much over the years?
I don't know that the mission of the archive has changed as much as its ability to sort of acquire material. In the last 7 years or so, the archive is acquiring material at a much more, you know, significant rate, and archiving films has become much better, you know, much easier to do in the digital age.
Did you ever imagine that when you started in this business as the in the late 60s and into the early 70s working with Malick, working with Altman, that you would ever be president of the Academy and using the phrase metadata?
I really am a child of the photochemical era, and I've kind of been, I don't want to say dragged, kicking and screaming. It never occurred to me that at some point in my life, not only would I be involved in making movies, but I would end up on the Board of Governors of the Academy and as its president. I mean, you know, life is so unpredictable, isn't it?